The pelargonium was brought from South Africa to Europe in the 17th century by Dutch plant hunters, and it resembled a plant native to Europe, the true geranium. And in their enthusiastic eagerness to classify their new discovery, it was incorrectly called the geranium. The rest, as they say, is horticultural history.
Although incorrectly named, they still gained popularity and found their way into the gardens of some of the grandest stately homes in the country.
This is Calke Abbey near Ticknell in Derbyshire, and what makes the Baroque mansion behind me so unique is that rather than being restored to its former historic glory, it has been preserved as a vivid example of a country house in decline. Today, there's a sort of poetic symbolism between the faded glory of this estate and the faded reputation of the glorious Pelargonium.
However, I am pleased to say that not all is lost at Calke Abbey, as the gardens here have been preserved to reflect their glory years, including a fascinating display of potted Pelargoniums. It's just a shame that we don't hold these colourful beauties in such high esteem anymore.
Personally, I find it very frustrating that people still today think of the Pelargonium as a cheesy seaside bedding plant or as a plant that's thrown away onto the compost bin at the end of the season. I want to show you that there is so much more to the glorious, humble Pelargonium.